offering is the truth, nothing more.
Could the mysteries of the ages ever be solved and explained? I am going to show you dots. These dots are events and mysteries that would never seem related, and yet they are. They all belong to one story, a story of paradise lost and found. There is a book that reveals this and connects these dots. But now, look at the dots. Dot 1. You were trapped in an alternate universe, one that was not intended to be. It is a fallen one that will end, and you are powerless to escape it. If you remain in it, you will end with it. I can prove it if you are willing to take a look. There is only one way out. You must accept that way by faith. Every other way is an illusion, just like the universe. It is a matrix, and I can prove it. Dot 2. You were told that it started with a talking snake in a garden with an apple and two naked people. There is more, and I can prove it. There is no talking snake. It was an upright, shining creature, one of deception. Does this guy look familiar? In 5 points, the book points to this guy as the one in the garden. Dot 3. Dot 3. You were also told that a flood killed most all life on Earth because people became bad. So an angry God who was fed up with mankind was responsible. That is not true. There is more to the story, and I can prove it by the book. This actually was an unusual time when non-human entities interfered with human history by interbreeding with humans, producing hybrid creatures, giants, and other distortions of nature, at the same time bestowing upon mankind forbidden knowledge of the eternal realm. They are back now and doing the same thing. I can also prove this by the book. Dot 4. You were told that there was another time of rebellion where man started a climbing program to reach into heaven by making a tower, built in a valley no less. Wait, there's more. This was an act of rebellion by building a tower to contain the memories of the forbidden physics that were provided by these same non-human entities before the flood, a physics that could be breached, the very time and space itself, and perpetuate life by cloning. I can prove this, it's in the book. Dot 5. You have been told that the many mystery spots on the Earth are normal achievements accomplished by primitive man. This is not true, and others have claimed that aliens help. This is also not true, and I can prove it by the book. Recently, researchers claim to discover specific measurements called a sacred geometry speak of events in the sky dating back to the time of the pre-flood world. The Tower of Babel account says that a contingency plan was established to build memorials and encrypt the forbidden information within the for future generations to understand it if God disbanded them and they were dispersed and the memorials were made. I can prove this by the book. Dot 6. The Nazis regime's occult beliefs of the SS Anunnaki in Lebensborn and Theosophy actually tried to restore this world before the flood and its hybrid people. They fulfilled many prophecies and even now are not finished with their agenda. I can also prove this by the book. Dot 7. The Nazi death camp experiments by SS Dr. Joseph Mengele on cloning and alien abduction genetic experiments and cattle mutilations are all one and the same and related to the books mentioned in the image of the beast. I can prove this by the book. Dot 8. George Washington had a three-part vision about America being saved in the last days by white spirits from the heavens. This is directly related to the book's mention of locusts coming out of the bottomless pit. It is a deception put upon mankind, and I can prove it by the book. Dot 9 says that America is part of the end-time beast empire that helps to bring about this new world order. It is also to be a refuge explained and ordained by God, but usurped by the enemy. I can prove this by the book. Dot 10 states there is an enemy, and he has a plan. The famous quotes of Satan in Isaiah, commonly called the five I wills, are symbolized by the pentagram and the Ouroboros. Encrypted in the Hebrew language is a five-point plan to eternalize this linear existence into an eternal one after his own fashion. This may have something also to do with 2012. I can show this to you in the book. Dot 11. A global conspiracy to create a one-world government, order, economy, and religion is real, and the book states that is a fact. Secret societies, current global events, Israel, and Islamic terrorists can be included as part of this dot. They are part of the story, and I can prove it by the book. Dot 12, the dawning of a new age or an ending of time as we know it. Time travel is already a done deal and described in this book. It is part of the end times, and I can prove it. All these dots connected tell a story that is truly beyond science fiction. The book is the translated meaning from the word Bible. This is the text that all of the dots come from. God, although written by man, inspires this most remarkable book with detailed truths and history that transcends our concept of space and time. Everything man will ever be confronted with or challenged with is here. Everything is accurate and true. Even what seems to us to be future events that we call prophecy is told by God as our history completed. All the dots are here, and we're waiting all this time for the right time to be revealed. As the prophet Daniel was given visions of the end of time and events leading up to that point, God told Daniel to write them down and seal them up in a book until a time when knowledge will increase and people would travel to and fro. The time is now. If any Bible code ever existed, it was in the Bible, interpreted by the Bible itself, and expounded by those called of God to reveal them. God's Bible code will not come from unbelievers using occult methods of encryption and computers. It is a book that is God-breathed, and by that same breath of His Holy Spirit only shall the scriptures be unlocked for His children that believe in Him. My book, Beyond Science Fiction, connects all the dots into one story. It has been the result of much fasting and prayer, and my claim alone is that most of the content is by revelation. I have diligently searched the scriptures to verify and explain these revelations by and with God's own word. I have combined this with 12 years of field work, which includes first-hand witness testimonies, investigations, and presenting my findings at many shows and conventions across the country. Living in Roswell, New Mexico for 4 years, I have seen the fruitful results of these truths transform many to a renewed belief in the God of the Bible and many others who are reconsidering this so-called New Age of Enlightenment. I do not expect you to believe or reject anything in this book. Just be open to consider the claims. If this is a correct work from the Lord, you will have a scriptural reference for many surprising events that will soon befall an unsuspecting world and church. I promise you that this is one of the most scriptural-backed comprehensive books written on the subject on the paranormal, UFOs, and alien agenda with respect to Bible prophecy so far. If nothing else, I will take you on a journey that is truly beyond science fiction. The book is now available at Amazon.com and BarnesandNoble.com. Thank you.